This presentation is about how to contribute to the GTAP database. The most common contribution that an individual can make to the GTAP database is the contribution of an input-output table. We've developed this website with the guidelines and information that will help you successfully contribute data to the GTAP database. And why would you like to contribute? Perhaps your country is not listed in the 100 plus countries that are reported in GTAP, and you wish to use the GTAP framework for an economic analysis. Or perhaps if the table is present in GTAP, you've noticed that there's more up-to-date information, or even if you are a subscriber, you realize that the data in GTAP doesn't really reflect what you had in mind about your country or what you know about your country. So by helping everyone, we will offer you, in exchange of your efforts, free access to the GTAP data. And we even have programs to facilitate this process. The contribution process starts with identifying a suitable table, and we would like for you to contact us right away as soon as you decide that you wish to contribute something to GTAP, because it may be the case that somebody else is already working on this. Then you will follow the guidelines of technical paper number one that specify the new format that we want the data to come so that we can run our programs easily. You should be aware that the number of sectors that we consider now are 65 and that we have new concordances. When we are ready to submit your data, you can do so through the GTAP website, and what we do in our end is review it and get back to you with feedback. So about the guidelines and what we check. The guidelines basically assure that the integrity of the database of the input-output table that you sent us is not compromised by the reformatting process. If the data is balanced at the beginning, it should be balanced at the end. This is one of the first things that we check. Now, the format that we require separates the value flows into pre and post taxes. That helps us check consistency. That helps us check easily by not allowing to have negative values in your flows, except of course for changes in stocks. In the new format of pre and post taxes, taxes are implicit. We still check that these taxes are not too large or the subsidies are not too large. If they find something that is oddly large, be that taxes or subsidies, we will get back to you for confirmation that this is in fact what the initial database represents. The new format expects that that you provide us a matrix of imported inputs, and we also will be checking cost structures for each industry so that we find nothing that is looking a bit strange. We will report all this to you, and we will work together in improving the quality of the GTAP database. Thank you.